In this video we will study another fundamental concept in system design. So here we will study about load balancing. So let's first understand what is load balancing. To understand it, let's see one motivating example. So I will take the same example as I took in my earlier video. So suppose you designed one great computer vision API and deployed it on your local machine. So what this API does, it takes as input one black and white image, and it returns a colored image of this, colored version of the same image. So it colored the trees as green and sun as yellow and so on. So this we call request and this is response. So suppose your API functions very well and people are liking the results and they are sharing it with others. So over time more and more people want to use your service and you are charging some money for that service, for using your API. So after some time, let's suppose your user base crosses 1,000 users, and after some time 10,000, then you saw that your machine is not very performant when the number of requests per second has increased rapidly and it has slowed down. So you decided to add few more computers and deployed the same APIs. So these all are servers and they are serving the request of the customers. So but how will you decide that which request should go to which computer? So a number of requests are coming per second. So you need some mechanism to distribute the load so that all of these computers are have well balanced load. So like if you have 1 million requests per second and you have let's say 10 computers, then it should go to 100,000 requests, approximately 100K requests per system, not exactly but close to that if all these systems are of similar power. So this, so that's why we need load balancing. So we need some algorithm so that when we have multiple requests coming per second, we need some algorithm and mechanism to distribute the load evenly among different servers. So that's why load balancing is very crucial in system design. Now let's see some of the features of load balancing. So the first feature, as we saw in the previous example, is to distribute the load or request across multiple resources or servers. Additionally, it should also keep track of the status of all resources while distributing the requests. So it may be possible that yesterday some of the machines were working, but today there is some problem and those servers are down due to some reason. So it's also the responsibility of load balancer to figure out that which server is working correctly, which server is healthy. So it keeps track of the health of servers also. This is another task of load balancer apart from distributing the load. So it will decide which server is not working by looking at the activity of the server. So if some server is not active for some time, then it can note down that this server is not active and it will stop sending traffic to this server and distribute the load on the remaining servers. And third function is to provide one mechanism where we can add or remove servers very easily on demand basis. Like if we take the example of some popular e-commerce websites like Amazon.com, then during some season like Christmas time or New Year or Black Friday sales, it's big billion days sales, so it's expected that the traffic will be much much more multifold compared to the traffic on some normal day. So at that time, in order to cater to the needs of the people, so Amazon will decide that it needs some extra server. So it should be very easy to add server for some time, and when the sale is over, it should be able to remove the server without too much of trouble. So load balancer should also provide some mechanism for easily adding or removing servers. Now let's look at where during system design, which where all we can add load balancer. So there are multiple places we can add load balancer. One example is like Amazon.com website. So user sends multiple requests, and then it can go through load balancer and distribute the load evenly to web servers. On the other hand, web servers themselves will be interacting with the backend servers. So here also load balancer can be used to distribute the load from web server evenly to the backend server. And finally, we could have multiple databases. For example, we may have multiple databases depending on catering to the needs of different regions. For different regions, we may keep different databases, and then internal server will be interacting with different database, and it will distribute the load evenly to the databases. So these are the three places where we can use load balancer. Now let's look at what are the algorithms used by load balancers. So first is a very natural and also very popular algorithm called round robin. So if we have three systems, then first request sent to first computer, first node, then second to second, third to third, and then fourth to again first, and so on. So it will equally distribute the requests to different machine one by one. And the next algorithm is least connections. So if this server is serving, let's say, 1000 requests, this is serving 800 requests per second, and this is serving 850 requests, then we see that this server has least number of requests sent to it, least number of connections. So next request we will forward it to second server. Now third is least response time. So it may depend on some factors like how many requests, number of requests being served by that system, and it may also depend on the power of system, how powerful the system is, or the configuration of machine. If we have a high-end machine, then that will be able to serve more requests as compared to some of the lower-end machines. So if we see that the response time is very less, that is, it's serving the request very fast, then that means that it can handle more requests, so we can route more requests to that server. Then the third one, fourth algorithm is IP hashing. So depending on the IP of from where the request is coming, we can route it to different servers. Like for some IPs, we would like that we should give priority to those IP addresses, and we will, depending on the IP address, we can create different hash function and serve the request differently. And the third, fifth method is URL hash. So depending on from which URL some request is coming from, like if it's coming from .in or .com or .co.in or .co.uk, like those. So we can have many more algorithms for URL hash also. So depending on URL hash also, you can distribute the load to different servers. So these were the main algorithms. Now let's summarize what we have seen in this video. So first we saw an example which showed why we need load balancing. So I hope that example is clear to all of you. And then we saw some of the features of load balancer. So these were the main three features: distribute the load, keep track of the health of the servers, and ease of adding and removing servers. Then we saw about where all we can use the load balancers. And finally, we saw the different algorithms that are popular in load balancing. So I hope this video will be very useful for you in designing your system. And all the best for your system design interviews, and stay tuned for my further videos. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.